Hey there guys, me Aaron here, back with a brand new video and a brand new episode of Album / EP Reconstruct Review. Last time we did Red Hot Chili Peppers, Stadium Arcade. It was a pretty good album. Zimmy knew it was very good. And this time we're doing Gray Days, The Phoenix, and which is Chester Bennington's first project before Linkin Park, but you know, this is their second album. First song is called Saturation, Strange Love. This beginning is kind of odd. This part though. And this is what I said. That was Strange Love, and very interesting beginning. I obviously, Chester's voice is pretty unmatched here. I mean, I love the grit in his voice when he says Strange Love. That's probably the best part of the whole song, and how he drags it out. That is just fucking amazing vocal talent right there. That's just I think that's probably my favorite part, absolutely. And yeah, no, it's a pretty good song overall. I feel like the instrumentals are pretty good as well. Like, it's alright. Like, I mean, you know? I don't necessarily love it the most, but you know, it's still pretty good. It's just a little bit eh. 8 out of 10 song overall. Next song is Starting to Fly. Okay. Okay. Very much new metal vibes. Oh yeah, this is like very Linkin Park new metal type stuff here. Is that Chester? I never heard him sing that low. Honestly, I didn't necessarily love that song, but for the most part, it was alright. I just bit on the meh side of things, but, you know, it was a pretty good song overall. I just did not necessarily love anything that happened. It's an alright bop. 6 out of 10. It's an alright song overall. It was just kind of meh overall, but, you know, it's just an alright song. Honestly, Chester's vocals are pretty good, but, you know, that's, probably where it begins and ends. The instrumental is alright. It's an instrumental. It's alright. I don't know. I guess that track didn't feel like it was, like, extremely interesting or anything, but it was alright overall. Alright, next song is Be Your Man. And, side note, I'm not, like, as emotional for some reason as when I listened to Amends on the channel. Like, I fucking broke down and cried, but for some reason, I guess it's not happening here. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is, man. Okay, okay. Perfume in the haze. Ashtray spread across the floor. His voice sounds odd here. Is that Chester? I'm questioning if that's Chester now. That was a good bop, nice Christian bop. I enjoyed that one. I like that it's like maybe about being insecure, that like God might not think that you care about following him or whatever. And I enjoy like discussion of those kind of struggles in Christian faith and stuff. Because I want to see more of that. Because then I, you know, might actually pay attention to, Christian radio. But, you know, I stopped listening a while ago. And I'm fine with that, honestly. Because a lot of it's just very samey in the lyrics and stuff. And nothing, like, never talks about, like, extreme struggles or anything like that. Anyways. Yeah, no, this one's pretty good. I like this one a lot. But... I like Chester's action, but I don't like it here. I mean, I assume like it seems like they are reusing older recordings of his voice and turning them into full-fledged songs. And so he was admittedly like 20, 30 years younger here. And you can really hear his accent and. That's just something I don't necessarily love, but I'm fine with it. It's just a little bit annoying sometimes. I like the song overall, though. 9 out of 10. Next song is Holding You featuring Dave Navarro. All right. Oh, okay. This has nu metal vibes to it. It's got the grooves. All right, I don't like that. His accent can just get like, oh man. I'm not loving that. It kind of kills the vibe of the track for me. Yeah, he had a really good voice, but I feel like he's overpronouncing some words and stuff, and it's just, it kind of ruins the song a little bit. And I don't feel good saying that, because I really love his voice, but just something about it here is just not doing it for me. Okay. Okay, this song is totally redeeming itself now. That was holding you in. I did not like it the most at the beginning until probably the middle part, but still, his accent just kind of shines through a little bit too much. I personally don't enjoy the pronunciation of some words, and that just kind of ruins my enjoyment. I know that's not really his fault of how he sounds, but I just, man, no. It's just, I can't totally get down with it, is all I'm trying to say here. I'm not trying to be mean or anything, really. It's just, I personally don't like how his accent sounds, and I just can't get over it because, I don't know, man. It's mostly fine. It's just a few bits here and there. 6.3 out of 10. Next song is Hole featuring Lily Bennington and Lila Bennington. Lila or Lila. His daughters, I assume. What? That was mostly fine. I'm not sure what they were going for at the beginning there, but that was okay too. This is alright. It's an alright song. I guess I don't have much to say about it. It was alright. 5.5 out of 10. I don't know, it was an alright song. It's pretty good. Next song is called Drag. Okay, hell yeah. Make me feel like I am real. Touch on me. All right. Drag me under you. Nice one. Fuck yeah. Feels bitter and sad, and I like that one a lot. 10 out of 10, definitely. Chester's voice is pretty nice. It sounded very broken here, I guess, and the lyrics pretty good as well. Next song is Believe Me featuring Richard Patrick.
Yeah.
That was alright. But I found myself getting kind of bored because the instrumentals are kind of just not doing it for me. I don't know. Kind of just boring at some point, I guess. But the song is alright for the most part. 6 out of 10. Next song is Anything Anything.
Okay, what is it tonight? Please just tell me what the hell is wrong. Do you wanna eat? Do you wanna sleep? Do you wanna shout? That love and happiness were the same. Now I'm older and I don't
care. I don't like this one. Not that the song's bad, I just don't enjoy the lyrics for the most part. Song's fine, it's just, I don't like the subject matter of the song, really. 7 out of 10. But I will probably not listen to this one again, I don't know. I don't really want to listen to it again. Anyways, next song is called Spin.
Pick up the pieces so that there's complications so that
I don't like how his voice sounds up a whole lot at all in this song. This part sounds fine. There's something about his voice here that I'm not loving that much. I hate to say that. Oh, okay. Solo? Okay, nice slow. A slow emotional solo. I hate to say that I really did not love that song a whole lot at all. It was fine until he started singing, and his voice sounded fine. I just don't enjoy how it sounded here. I don't know how to explain what I mean exactly. I was not really feeling his voice on this one this time. Everything else was fine, though, just that one bit, I wasn't loving that a whole lot. 5 out of 10. I'm sorry if anyone's upset by that. I wasn't loving that bit. Anyways, the last song is called Wake Me.
Yeah.
Alright, his accent again. I don't hate it though this time, I guess. So, that song was Wake Me, and it was pretty alright. There wasn't, like, a whole lot there that was amazing, but the vocals were mostly solid, and, the instrumentals were pretty good as well. I mean, it's kind of just, like, kind of blends with all the other songs, except for a couple that I really disliked, but, you know, it was a fine song and a fine way to end the album. Just, the ending just felt of the album, I feel like this wasn't a good way to end the album in terms of instrumentation. But, you know, it was fine. 7.5 out of 10. Overall, the album was very much just alright. Just alright. I mean, there was nothing here that I necessarily loved, except for a couple of songs, maybe like Strange Love and maybe one other one. But, yeah, no, overall the album is a 7 out of 10, because I didn't love a whole lot of songs. I didn't love his accent or, like, the instrumental district. I mean, I liked them, but there wasn't here that really got me, like, well, this is, like, really, really great or anything like that. Yeah, but that's pretty much it. Anyways, that's it for this video. Think, create most poorly, stay alive, and next time we're doing Panic at the Disco, A Fever You Can't Sweat Out.